And in my view, there is nothing more dangerous than an unethical president who believes they are above the law. We are better than that.
At the close of the session, Adam Schiff, the chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, denounced the Republicans who called the hearings a show trial. On the fifth day of the public phase of impeachment hearings, the committee heard testimony from two witnesses, Fiona Hill, a former White House national security adviser, and David Holmes, the political counsellor at the US Embassy in Ukraine. Hill, a Russia expert, said she had sometimes clashed with Gordon Sondland, the US ambassador to the EU, for not being cooperative, but that she understood why after hearing his testimony on Wednesday.
He was being involved in a domestic political errand, and we were being involved in national security foreign policy, and those two things had just diverged.
A domestic errand, the term made it clear that she saw Trump's pressure campaign on Ukraine as personal, not intended to serve national security interests. The hearings from a total of 12 witnesses focused on whether the US president, through his personal lawyer Rudy Giuliani, pressed his Ukrainian counterpart Volodymyr Zelensky to publicly announce an investigation into Joe Biden in exchange for a White House meeting. The most stunning revelation came from Sondland, who had donated generously in Trump's election campaign.
Was there a quid pro quo? With regard to the requested White House call and the White House meeting, the answer is yes. Everyone was in the loop.
This came after Marie Yovanovitch, the former U.S. ambassador to Ukraine, testified to being the subject of a smear campaign by Giuliani before being recalled from her post. A National Security Council member, Alexander Vindman, called Trump's dealings with Zelensky improper. Democrats are discussing their next move, whether to end the public phase of the hearings and to pass over to the House Judiciary Committee.